Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we'll give more detail about drug-target interactions with an emphasis on enzyme and receptor targets. By the end of this video, students will be able to describe enzyme inhibition, define receptor agonists, inverse agonists, and antagonists, and list major receptor superfamilies. Enzymes are our first target. Enzymes are almost always proteins made in the body. They are molecular machines that bind a substrate and transform it into a product. The reaction occurs at the active site on the surface of the enzyme. Drugs that target an enzyme are typically inhibitors that bind and block the active site and therefore shut down the function of the enzyme. Below is a general enzymatic scheme. Toward the middle, we have the substrate, enzyme, and inhibitor. If the enzyme binds a substrate, you get an enzyme-substrate complex that rapidly forms the product. If, however, the enzyme instead binds the inhibitor, you get an enzyme-inhibitor complex which is not able to bind the substrate to make product. Other modes of inhibition are possible, but this scheme applies to most enzyme inhibitor drugs. Receptors are also proteins made in the body. Receptors are switches that control biological pathways, can turn on or off a pathway. Molecules that control the switch are called ligands. Natural ligands, endogenous ligand in the body that binds and turns on the receptor is an agonist. Drug ligands, which tend to be unnatural to the body, exogenous, can have many functions. Drug ligands that turn a receptor on are called agonists. Drugs that turn off the receptor are called inverse agonists. Drugs that do nothing except block the agonist binding are called antagonists. Receptors are often subdivided into superfamilies based on similarities in structure and function. The first superfamily in this list is the G protein-coupled receptor, GPCR. GPCRs are membrane-bound receptors. They are common targets for drugs that address metabolic disorders. The slow neurotransmitters like serotonin and dopamine also bind GPCRs. The next superfamily includes the ligand-gated ion channels. These are also membrane-bound. Ligands for ion channels include fast neurotransmitters like glutamate. Next are the tyrosine kinase-linked receptors, or TKLRs, which are also membrane-bound. TKLRs are often targets of cancer drugs. Finally, we have the nuclear receptors, which are not membrane-bound and found in the nucleus. Endogenous ligands for nuclear receptors include various steroids. There are other ways to categorize receptors, but this method is common. Are enzymes and receptors the only drug targets? No, not at all. Most targets are receptors or enzymes, but there are others. DNA is a target for many early cancer drugs. RNA has become a more popular target as methods for designing RNA-binding drugs have become better understood. Proteins that are neither enzymes nor receptors are sometimes targeted by drugs. Examples include the structural protein, tubulin, hemoglobin, the oxygen-carrying protein, and various transporter proteins found throughout the body. We have now covered enzymes as targets for inhibition, the different types of receptor ligands, as well as the most commonly cited examples of receptor superfamilies. As always, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video about targets and types of ligands. If you are so inclined, please be sure to leave a like, make a comment, or subscribe to the channel. Take care.